Hiya crafters, Amy here with another Back to Basics, and this video is about die cutting and filling up my sentiment binder. So here is my sentiment binder. This one is for specifically like sentiment die cuts for batching my cards. I do have a separate binder for my colored and stamped critters, but basically I was asked recently to make a video about how I fill up this binder and how I choose what cardstocks and things like that. So I'm just going to show you some very basic die cutting for these sentiments, and also just a couple tips on how I choose what to fill it up. So if you're an experienced crafter, this would probably be an old hat for you and maybe not of interest. But for those of you just starting out, maybe you'll get some little tips and tricks along the way. So here's a couple pieces of unused metallic cardstock. I have one that's holographic and one that's gold. And then you can see here I have a bunch of scraps of pattern paper and partially used scraps of paper and things like that. So this is kind of what I do. I'll just kind of go through my scrap drawer and use up whatever I can. I'll kind of sit around and, you know, pick a day to kind of fill up the sentiment book. Or in this case, you can see these are three new to me dies. So a lot of times when I get new sentiment dies, I'll kind of just block out a little bit of time and then just cut out a bunch of them in all different sorts of colors and pattern papers and things like that, and then add them to my sentiment book. So that way they don't just sit there unused. And I'll be sure them in the book. Now here I was showing you the washi tape on the top plate of my embossing or die cutting machine. I put the tape on there to indicate that that's my top plate. The reason I do that is so that I always use that one on the top and then the other one on the bottom. So it kind of keeps some of the marring from kind of messing up the things that I die cut. As you probably have noticed, die cuts get marred up and cut up really quickly. You can see mine are quite ugly, but when I designate the one for the top, it really does help from kind of messing up my die cuts and getting too many imprints from the cuts on the plate. So that's a little tip. If you want to designate one of your plates to always being on the top, then it will kind of help. And you can see here, I'm just doing some very simple die cutting. I have a little pokey tool to kind of poke out the little pieces parts. And you can see I grabbed that purple foam. Sometimes that will help you if you have little fiddly dies like this and you really need to poke out a bunch of little spots. Sometimes kind of lifting it up at an angle and then poking down through into a foam sheet can really kind of help you get the pieces parts out. So here I'll show you, I'm basically just using the base plate here, and then it gives you instructions on my particular unit, and then I'm just using the two standard cutting plates, and then, you know, the sandwich of the paper and the die. So I'm moving through it pretty quickly, but most embossing machines are the same concept. You just need to see which sandwich is correct for your specific die cutting machine. Now here I'm showing you, I did cut out some of the shadow layers of the dies with some pattern paper. I thought those might work well with, you know, maybe a white or a black. And here you can see you can combine white and black. So really I don't put a whole lot of thought into it. I kind of just use what I have. And then by having it ready to go in the binder, then I can kind of just pick whatever works for my specific card. Now this is how I store them. These are baseball card protector pockets. I have recently acquired a different kind that has a little bit of a lip that kind of helps hold them in. So the tip would be, if you have the kind that don't have the little lip like I'm showing here, then maybe just don't fill them too full and then they won't kind of spill out on you. But you also don't want to fill them too full, just because if they're more delicate like this, you don't want them to get stuck on each other when you're trying to pull them in and out and then end up ripping your paper. So there's not really a whole lot to this. I hope you find this helpful. You can see some of them, I maybe left the little pieces parts within the letters, and that just kind of helps give them some stability while they're in those little pockets. And then I'll just, you know, poke out those little bits later. So I hope you found this helpful. Like I said, it's for more newbie crafters. But if you enjoyed it, please hit the thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel, and I'll check you next time. Thanks.